This video uses the C# language and the default collections present in the .NET framework. However, the concept I'm about to present is also applicable to other languages. With that said, let's take a quick look at the default collections that the .NET framework provides: a list, dictionary, hashset, linked list, queue, and stack. There are some other collections, like the concurrent collections, but let's not go into those details. All default collections have their own specific use cases. However, when dealing with large amounts of entries, performance becomes an important factor to take into account, and the choice of which collection to use is often determined by how you intend to use it. For example, a list is very suited for when you need an ordered collection where you can easily add stuff to the back. However, when you want to insert and delete elements to an arbitrary location in the list, the performance of the list gets worse. A dictionary has a very fast lookup operation, but there the order of the elements is lost. Wouldn't it be great if there was a collection that has a great performance for all operations? First, let's talk a little about complexity theory and the big O notation. The big O stands for the order of complexity. It can be about execution time, but also about other aspects like memory usage. In this video, I'll focus on the execution time of operations on a collection. An operation with complexity in the order of 1 means it will take a constant amount of time regardless of the number of elements in the collection. A dictionary lookup is such an example where the time it takes to access an element given a key is fixed and not dependent on the number of elements in the collection. A constant speed doesn't mean it's necessarily fast. It only means that the execution time is independent from the number of elements in the collection. It can still be a slow operation. Still, if you have a large amount of elements in your collection, constant speed operations are preferred. You can also have operations that scale logarithmically. An example is doing a binary search, which is how you usually look up a name in a phone book. An operation in the order of n means it scales linearly to the amount of elements in the collection. Searching a list to figure out if a value is present or not is an operation that scales linearly. Note that it doesn't matter if the item you're searching for is the first item in the list or the last. The order of complexity is a concept that looks at the operation in general. In general, a list with 10 times as many items will take 10 times as long to search through. There are many other orders of magnitude, but I won't go into details for them all. If you are doing basic operations on a collection with a small number of elements, you shouldn't worry too much about the complexity of the operations. However, when you have millions or billions of items in the collection, then it really matters whether the operation is order of n, the order of log n, or constant speed. Let's take a look at a real-world use case I ran into in the past. I needed a collection with the following properties. It needed to be an ordered collection which was usable in a for each statement. I needed to be able to look up whether an item was already present in the collection or not. I needed to be able to add items to the front and back, and to be able to insert an item in the middle directly before an existing item. I needed to be able to remove an item from the collection. And I needed all of these operations to be performant with hundreds of millions of elements in the collection. And this last requirement really meant I was looking for a collection where all these operations took a constant time. So, let's first take a look at the existing .NET collections and per operation see which collection can do that operation in constant time. The list, linked list, and queue all keep order within the collection. But to be able to have an efficient lookup, you need a dictionary or hashset. Adding items to both the back and front can be done in constant time with the linked list. inserting in the middle in constant time, can only be done with a linked list, assuming you have access to the corresponding linked list node. Efficiently removing an item can be done with a dictionary or hashset, or with a linked list if you have access to the corresponding linked list node. To explain why certain operations can be done in constant time on a linked list if you have access to the corresponding linked list node, let's take a look at the inner workings of the linked list. A linked list is built up of nodes, and each node holds a reference to the item stored in that node, and to the node directly before and after it. It's literally a chain of nodes linked together. The front property of the linked list points to the first node points to the second node points to both the first and the third node, etc. Now, let's say we want to insert a fifth item just before the third item. First, you would do a linear search over the nodes to find the node that contains the third item. Then it changes the pointers of the second and third node to point to the new node. Due to the linear search, this is an order n operation. However, here comes the fun part. If you have already access to the third node, you can skip the linear search. The whole insert operation is now reduced to a constant speed operation. But how can we get instant access to the third node if we only have the third item available? Well, with a dictionary, of course. For each item in our collection, we can store the corresponding linked list node in a dictionary. Now we can do all required operations in constant time. Let's go over all of the required operations and what the implementation looks like. Our constant speed collection consists of a linked list and a dictionary, which maps the items to the corresponding linked list nodes. To be able to use it in a for each statement, we need to implement the IEnumerable interface. We can simply forward this call to the linked list. Doing a lookup whether an item is already present in the collection can be done efficiently using the dictionary. Next, we need to add an item to the front and back. When adding an item to the linked list, we actually get the corresponding linked list node returned. We store that node in the dictionary. To insert an item, we first look up the corresponding linked list node in the dictionary. Then, using that node, we can insert the item into the linked list. The returned node is again stored in the dictionary. Deleting an item also means we first do a lookup in the dictionary, then remove the item from the dictionary and remove the node from the linked list. And we're done. We could do some extra optimizations, such as instantiating the dictionary with an initial capacity to reduce the amount of internal resizing operations, but I'll leave that to you. Note that I didn't have the need to store duplicate items in the collection. The presented solution doesn't work when duplicate items are needed. However, if you change the dictionary to store a collection of linked list nodes per item, then duplicate entries are possible with only minimal performance penalties.